presented by Church Tech U. It's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to have multiple versions of ProPresenter on the exact same computer so that you can go between them at any time. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach you all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've ever thought, man, I just wish I could quit out of ProPresenter and start a different version real quick, go ahead, subscribe, thumbs up, like the video, all that fun jazz. So this has come up fairly recently where someone says, look, I downloaded a version and I'm having a little bit of an issue with it. How can I downgrade given that sometimes I actually want the new features? And sometimes I just want features from a previous version. No problem. It's really not all that hard. Now, I will say that I'm going to show you this in macOS. And it might be different in Windows. I haven't actually booted into Windows to check it. But with that in mind, I think this is a helpful trick just so that you know what's going on. So let's head over to my computer and we'll take a look. So here we are in Chrome, and I just went to renewedvision.com. Well, if you click on download up here and select ProPresenter, it will ask you for some information. If you haven't signed up for that, you absolutely should, so they can let you know, for example, when beta versions come out. And cool stuff on the ProPresenter users community that Renewed Vision and I have partnered together for. If you've already done that or just don't have time, do it later. This button down here, download only, will take you to the download page. So you can download that, select which one you want. This is the current version for macOS. This is the current version for Windows. If instead you want an older version, click on version history and it will show you all the versions of ProPresenter back to ProPresenter 5. Well, it says ProPresenter 5, but that's ProPresenter 6, so I think that that's actually a mistake here. So there is ProPresenter 6 right there. Oh, yeah, it is ProPresenter 533. Sorry. So we can go back and we can have multiple versions. Keep in mind that on macOS at least, these are no longer supported in current versions of macOS. And some of these are maybe going to give you some issues as well. So let's say that I wanted 7.9.2. I could click on this and download it and save it onto my computer. Now, once I move that into my applications folder, it would ask me if I wanted to override it. But you might notice what I've got going on here. Now, I say that it's not supported and Pro 6 is not supported, even though I'm on the latest version of macOS as of September 29th. Not on the beta, but I am on the latest shipping version. So I can sometimes get it to work okay for answering questions that I've forgotten the answers to. But that said, on Apple Silicon Macs, it's iffy at best. So just keep that in mind. But you'll notice that I have several other versions of ProPresenter 7. Notice that we've got the same icon for all these. So I've got this that just says ProPresenter. Then I've got ProPresenter 7.9, 7.9.2, 7.10, and 7.10.2 beta. So if I wanted to go from, let's say I'm on the beta of 7.10.2, so I click on About ProPresenter here, it shows you that. So what I could do is I could close out ProPresenter. Do you want to do this? Yeah, I'm going to do it. Okay, and now if I want to go to 792, I can just double click on that. And it pops right up in 792. And notice that did affect, this is why I was hesitating, because it did affect that, but I can click back over here and should be able to click on it. I have been having trouble with my DeckLink Duo 2, so might be a little issue with that. But in general, I can go back and forth between different versions of ProPresenter pretty easily like that. So if I want to go back to 7.10.2, I can just click on my normal shortcut there, or I could have clicked on that other one, and that should take me there. Let's see. Yep, I'm going to have to play with this afterwards, but that would that enables me to switch between different versions as I would like in ProPresenter 7. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course, which is available right there. TDM.fyi/pro7quick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you. Till next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.